Good morning, everyone. We're here at the Natural History Museum. It's going to be a very interesting morning. We're going to do a lot of our stuff in the dark. Not that I'm clueless, but, you know, in the dark, dark. Literally, the dark, right? All right, I'm hanging out with Courtney, who's going to give us some really cool demonstrations as we explain the principles behind this really cool exhibit, Nature's Bioluminescence, correct?
Yes.
And, well, the official name is...
Creatures of Light.
Creatures of Light. There you go. Okay, so, all right, Paige, knock that light off. Here we go. We're in the dark now, sister. All right.
Fantastic. So, yeah, I wanted to talk a little bit more about the difference between bioluminescence and fluorescence.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the creatures we're talking about in here create their light through bioluminescence, which is a chemical reaction.
Right.
So if you want to take one of your glow sticks.
Yes.
I gave you two. You can pick your favorite color.
Mm-hmm.
Glow sticks are not bioluminescence, but it's a chemical reaction that produces its glow. So when you crack that glow stick, you actually have two chemicals combining.
Yeah.
And if you kind of work it a little bit, it'll start to glow.
Starts
and that's kind of what's happening in a firefly or in the dinoflagellates, which you'll get to meet a little bit later.
There we go.
They have two chemicals that are combining, and then it produces that burst of glow.
Like this.
This is... Yeah, this will keep glowing because the chemicals are constantly kind of mixing and working together. But in the creature, it's a bright burst, and they can stop, and they can, you know, do it all over again, depending on...
Now, this guy...
Yeah. Check this out. So this is a scorpion, not native to Ohio, so you have nothing to worry about.
Mm-hmm.
But they are fluorescent. So fluorescence happens when you have the interaction of, like, energy and atoms. It's a very... fancy science thing that's going on with him.
And you're putting a black light on this guy.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So there's something in his chitin.
Like a regular light.
Yeah. Ooh. Regular light? Yeah. So he's got like a brownish color to him.
See? No biggie. But then we take that off and boom, boom, boom. Look at that. That is just pretty cool.
He almost looks like alien or unreal. But that is something that happens in nature.
That's pretty essence. Okay, and so over here, speaking of the black light, these
look
like regular rocks, but...
So these are minerals, and there's some... different minerals that will also fluoresce.
Mm-hmm. So we have some here.
Yeah.
And we see that here, then we take it off, and now we see it glow. Yes, and then over here, and we see it glow. Yep.
And yeah, then that's what they look like, just in the regular light. So again, there's something happening with the black light and with the mineral itself that creates that really beautiful fluorescent glow.
That's pretty cool. When we come back, lots more to show you guys. And that the scorpion's name is what?
David Glowy.
David Glowy. Ah, nice. When we come back, really cool stuff at the Natural History Museum. Stay with us.
Fox 8 News in high def.